Welcome to the 2015-16 school year. It is truly a great day in the Ann Arbor Public Schools as we come together to launch an exciting new school year. We're especially delighted this year to continue with our theme, Lead, Care, Inspire. And for this 2015-16 school year, we will focus on the core value of care. I want to thank each of you for serving on our team, and thank you for the extra care that you show every day in your work. In AAPS, we consistently create a community of care in every one of our schools. Care is an important part of what makes the Ann Arbor Public Schools the exceptional organization that it is. Thank you for being a part of our Ann Arbor Public Schools team this school year. Certainly, we know that caring isn't always easy. Yet the practice of care transforms our lives and our work together each day. When we care well for ourselves is when we are most capable of caring for others. We all live in conscious care for our students, for they are at the very heart of everything we do. Caring is really seeing another individual and consciously choosing to uplift through our thoughts, our words, and our actions. For so many of us, whether we have served on the Ann Arbor team for only a short time or for an extended career, we resonate with the practice of care. We are all fortunate in our schools to live in an environment already steeped in care. I'm humbled on a daily basis as I observe your many acts of care. Your capacity to care is impressive. You go above and beyond the basic requirements of the job to demonstrate care through your daily actions. Most of these acts of caring may appear to go unnoticed, and yet this year we want to lift them up and celebrate what they mean to our success as an AAPS team. I hope you will appreciate these examples of caring shared from some of our own team members.
During our summer program, our janitorial staff worked very hard to start the cleaning of our building for the next school year, but they also were really careful to work around the kids and the teachers who were learning in that space. And I think it demonstrates the utmost caring that they're willing to accommodate us in the building, but also take on this really big task of cleaning our building for the next school year.
The science department chair, Andrew Collins, we eat lunch in his room as a science department, and he kind of eats lunch with us, but really it's him answering questions of students on a daily basis.
A staff person had told me, or shared with me rather, that a parent confided in her one morning and said that she was having some financial difficulties and she was a little concerned about putting food on the table for her child. Unbeknownst to anyone, the staff person went home in between her shifts, gathered up a bag of canned goods, brought it back to the school, and discreetly gave it to the parent when the parent came to pick up her child at 6 o'clock p.m. The parent was very touched, and I think I'm a little bit relieved that that's one little thing she didn't have to worry about.
On the hottest day of the school year, I noticed two parents out here working, drenched in sweat, trying to beautify our courtyard so our students can have more learning space outdoors versus indoors. They've used jackhammers, they've gotten their hands dirty by digging into the soil, lifting heavy rocks, making something that is a useful, beautiful space usable for students.
Several years ago, we ended up at a visitation there was a family of students at our school whose mother suddenly passed away. And sometimes at visitations, when, you know, everybody's there to pay their condolences and there's lots of kids, kids can get kind of lost in the crowd and they don't know what to do and they're upset. And it's hard for them to deal with those emotions. And I remember one coworker in particular who just put her arm around the little boy who had been in her class, and she stuck to him like glue. And she just really kind of filled in where mom, you know, couldn't be.
Lady that trained me, actually, to be a driver, She was dropping off a student. And everything was fine. She was getting ready to open the door. She checked her mirrors one more time, and she noticed that there was a driver coming up on the sidewalk, of all things. The young man that was first to get off, he was just getting ready to get off, and she yanked him by his hoodie, just pulled him back. That driver would have hit him if she hadn't done that, and she saved his life.
I definitely think that Ann Arbor has a lot of caring staff. I think that's very typical for Ann Arbor teachers. I've taught in other states, and this is different.
I think our staff go above and beyond each and every day in ways that are never publicized, in ways that sometimes we as administrators don't even know.
And it doesn't matter what the situation is, they'll go out of their way to make sure it happens for them. They lose their lunch money, they'll give them money for lunch. If they can't find their way, they'll get it from the desk and they'll take them where they need to go. If the locker's stuck, we'll call the custodian comes right away and helps them with their situation.
I think the needs of the kids are first, right? That in our district, I think that's what we're all engaged in, putting kids first. And I think that happens from the office to the janitorial staff to the food service staff to our teachers and our principals, our special ed staff. And all of us are working hard at putting kids first, and there are these small moments in people's days and weeks where they invest in that big picture.
The people that do this kind of work, it seems like they have a bigger vision of what the world can be and the possibilities that are available through demonstrating how much they care.
It's all about that relationship building, to me, is what is most important. And that involves me caring about them, because I do.
And so we anchor ourselves this year in the core value of care. We will continue throughout this year to share inspiring stories from your work in our schools. We'll explore together the practices that promote the habit of caring, learning more about how care relates to our work together. Exuding care transforms our own lives for the better. It is a formula guaranteed to enrich a day, a career, our organization, and our community. Care is a commitment that never fails. So as we begin this school year, certainly we will finalize lesson plans, prepare our classrooms, and make sure that we're up to date on the latest requirements. But what makes Ann Arbor Public Schools truly special is more than the curricula, the extracurriculars, even the arts and the athletics. Caring is the key to creating a quality educational experience for all our students. Today, Ann Arbor Public Schools staff, I want to share with each of you my firm commitment as superintendent to rededicate myself this year to caring as a fundamental daily practice. I hope you will join me as we continue our focused work together to deepen our practice of care, and in doing so, to make this 2015-16 school year the best year possible for ourselves, our colleagues, and for every one of our 17,000 students and their families in the exceptional Ann Arbor Public Schools. I'm Jeanice Swift, Superintendent of Schools, and I care.
My name is Wendy Rothman. I'm the PYP facilitator at Mitchell Elementary School, and I care.
My name is Ilana Levine. I teach kindergarten at Hazley Elementary. I care.
My name is Donetta Brown. I'm the general office manager here at Huron High School, and I'd like you to know that I do care.
I'm Todd Newell. I am the IB Middle Years Program Facilitator at Huron, and I care.
My name is Nicole Davis, and I'm a teacher at Skyline High School, and I care.
My name is Che Carter, and I care.
Hi, I'm Joanne Taylor, and I'm the office manager at Hazley Elementary. I've been here for 16 years because I care.
Hi, I'm Brody Brocky, Skyline Office Manager. I care.
We're from First Steps and we care.
I care and we care.
Safe! I care.
I teach a preschool science class for Rec and Ed, and I care.
I care.
My name is Barbara, and I care.
I care.
I care.
I care.
I care.
We care.
We care.
I care.
I care.
I care.
We care.
I care.
I care.
We care.